Before you can do any mapping applications, you need to get a key that gives you access to the Google Maps Android API. This is pretty easy to do, but it involves taking a few steps out of Android Studio for the time being. You're going to be working in Terminal. So as you can see, I've opened my Terminal here. The first thing you need is the SHA-1 fingerprint for your app. Google Maps uses this as a way to identify your application so it can give your app good service. This fingerprint is a machine-readable attribute of a certificate, and a certificate is a way of determining that your app is real. Just like in the real world, a certificate is a sign of an authority where you can call upon a third party to certify that you are who you say you are. Now we're just going to use a debug certificate for this as it's easier for learning purposes. The debug certificate is issued to you by yourself. Now later, if you want to release your app to the Play Store, you'll need a publication certificate which is verified by Google. If you want to do that, follow the instructions on the developer website linked below. The first thing that you'll need to do is to locate your key store file for debugging using the terminal. It's called, imaginatively enough, debug.keystore. On a Mac or Linux, it's at cd:\.android. So note that when you put a dot in front of a folder like this, it's usually hidden, so just note that you may need to unhide it. If you're using Windows, it'll be at c:\\.your username:\.android. And remember, it could also be hidden on Windows. This is the directory that contains the debug.keystore, and I can use this to get the fingerprint. And I'll show you how to do that next. The command to get the certificate is the keytool command. And the keytool command, you tell it your keystore. And you can see the keystore location is .android/debug.keystore. You also just give it an alias. I'm calling it the Android debug key. And the password and username is just Android when you're using debug. So when I press enter, you'll see my SHA key is listed in the certificate. The certificate fingerprints are here, MD5, SHA1, and SHA256. So just keep track of the SHA1 key. I would just recommend leaving the terminal window open because you'll be needing that data in a moment.